It's a nice way to know the background of the word Hindu. It doesn't come directly from what we are all about. So what are we all about? As I said, trying to make sense of the human condition. And the term that the Hindus themselves use to define their enterprise is dharma. The word dharma comes from the Sanskrit root dhara. Dhara means what is it that's holding everything together? What is behind this creation? What is one out of which everything is manufactured, including all the non-living things, the living things, human beings, intellect, emotions? What is the foundation to everything? What holds everything together? Dhara. From the word dhara, we derive the word dharma. So trying to resolve the human condition was defined as the enterprise called dharma, making sense of the human condition. And resolving the human condition becomes, if you like, practicing dharma, sorting yourself out. The word dharma then also had an addition, the word sanatan. Sanatan means we are trying to resolve the human condition, which is not just temporarily fed, means only suitable for one particular, group of people during a particular period of history, but something that has got eternal values or universal values. That is the word sanatan. So the word sanatan dharma is the real name of the religion of Hinduism. So sanatan dharma means we want to try and find, if you like, resolution to our human condition, which is permanent, not just temporary, not a fad, but which is permanent and which is universal. So it doesn't only apply to one particular part of the country. It must be a universal phenomena. In fact, it should resolve the condition of human condition throughout the world. This is the meaning of the word sanatan dharma. Now, if you talk to any logician, any clear thinker, that what this is what we are trying to sort out. What is the nature of reality? What are the rules and laws that operate in the world that I see around me? Let me understand those rules and laws and harness them for my betterment. They say, Mr. Lakhani, you're talking our language. Talk to any scientist. A physical scientist, a hard scientist who's studying physics and chemistry, or a soft scientist looking at psychology and anthropology. They say, this is our enterprise, trying to make sense of the world that we live in. What are the rules that world operate in the world around us? If we know how to, if we can come to terms with those rules, we can harness them for our betterment. This is hard sciences. And the same thing is true with soft sciences like psychology and anthropology, trying to understand the human condition. What are the rules that operate with human beings, individually or as groups, as social groups? Sociology. So understanding the rules and laws that operate in this world and coming to terms with them and harnessing them for our betterment is the actual definition of the word dharma, sanatan dharma. Now you can see how well it sits with the concept of modern scientific thinking. That's what science is all about. The reason why you study physics is because I can understand this called electromagnetism, this called gravitation. I can understand the rules that they operate and harness them so I can send a man to the moon and bring him back. This is the enterprise of science. That's why we harness nature. You see, in ancient days when you had thunderstorms, you say, oh, God sending messages, we are crying and cowering in a cave and shuddering. Now we say, oh, no, this is called electricity. We harness it, put it in wires, and light up our rooms. This is harnessing nature. And what about harnessing inner nature? If you understand what are the emotions, the drives that drive human beings, like you've got tremendous attraction, you've got some tremendous desires. If we can come to terms of what is the origin of desires and harness them, we are harnessing nature internal. You see, this is the idea of social sciences. So in a way, the word dharma encompasses or uses, if you like, a very, very broad term that encompasses, if you like, the issues of hard sciences as well as soft sciences. It's a very, very rigorous term, dharma. So what you thought was, dharma, that's the name of religion. It's not religion. The word religion is an enterprise, Abrahamic enterprise, which says, trying to link or relate humanity with some super personality called, oh Lord, you are God. What's the link between God and man? This is called religion, realigning humanity with God. Hinduism is not that, it's dharma. And let me also tell you, the word dharma is a very vast term, not just used by Hindus. It is common to Hindus, Buddhists, Jains, and Sikhs. All the four Indic religions that came out of India, relate to the word dharma. They share the word dharma. In Buddhism, they don't talk about God at all, but yet it's dharma, making sense of the human condition. So in the same one, the one term encompasses the four major world religions, I would say half the population in the world belong to the dharmic faiths. It's not a minor thing. And they all relate to the word dharma. I said with the adjective sanatan means we are looking for permanent solution to human condition, not just temporary fad that's suitable for 50 years or 20 years and then it'll fade away. No good. So if you like, this is the foundation of the word dharma. It's very important for you to know.